What's up, Charms? I am back with another pick a card, and today's pick a card is going to be in regards to Mi Santísima Muerte. So this is another video that could help us along with our journey with our Santísima Muerte for those devotees, for the curious, or those who are really starting to work with her. This is my second video. I do have another video on my channel, and I received another request from one of my viewers to create another video like this. It did take me a while to create another video as I was in vacation, but now I'm back. It's going to be a short and simple video. There is three piles here. Again, there's two cards in each pile. It's going to be short and simple. I also have some channeled messages that I channeled from her before I started this video. I am using the Santísima Muerte Oracle deck, which is this one. There is also a Santísima Muerte tarot deck. So if any of my viewers feel like, you know, donating the deck to my channel, please do so, as I could create more videos like this and I could receive more information and channel more information with the tarot deck. I will link my wish list down below if anybody feels called to donating that tarot, Santísima Muerte tarot deck to me, so I can create more videos and content like this. So thank you again for requesting another video like this. So let's get right into it. So I have pile one, pile two, and pile three. I have my Santísima Muerte, Siete Potencias right there. So let's get to it. So if you guys are ready to dive into the reading, the timestamps will be pinned down below. If you need more time, go ahead and pause the video. Ask her what messages do you need to receive right now. What do you need to know right now? Once you pick your pile, go ahead and click on the timestamps down below. Pile one. If you pick pile one, this is your reading. So for pile one, the channel messages, before I go into the cards that I picked, the messages that I received from you guys, the first one that I heard was rest. So I don't know if you guys need some rest or need to rest, might be depleted of energy, or are in need of some rest, of rejuvenation of your energy. Since sometimes when you're tired, it's kind of hard to kind of, you know, work with the energies with her, or to hear her guidance, or to connect with her. So if you're in need of some rest, please make sure to take that rest, as that is coming up. The second thing that I heard is cleanse altar. So it's either you need to cleanse her altar or pick up a resume of, you know, cleansing her altar maybe once a week, you know, picking a specific day and cleansing her altar. Or you might have just cleansed her altar or are doing it right now. So that might be just a kind of, you know, letting you know that she knows and she's aware of what's going on. So make sure to, you know, you're cleansing her altar. Make sure you remove everything, cleanse her, you know, and the statues, everything that's placed on her altar. Make sure to refreshing everything every time you cleanse her altar. So the third thing that I heard was food, and then I heard delicious. So I don't know if you may be wondering what type of food to offer her. If you have been offering her food or meals, know that she loves it, and she's saying that it's been very delicious, the food that you have been offering her. And if you've been wondering if you could offer her food, the answer is yes. So sometimes, you know, when I'm cooking, I'll get a sensation of her wanting the food that I'm cooking, or, you know, she'll give me a sign or something, or she'll manifest in my food or something. That's when I know she wants that food or she wants a dish. So that's when I will give her some food. You know, if anything that I'm baking, I'll tend to give her some too. So, you know, just depending of what you want to offer her. There's no right or wrong answer of what you could offer her in regards to food. She loves fruits, especially red fruits. You know, she loves apples, red apples, and I have found that the deeper the red they are, the better they are for her, and the more that she loves it. So that's one thing. The next thing that I heard was retrieve. So I don't know exactly what that could mean. I don't know if you've been trying to retrieve something for her, or there's a need to retrieve something that you lost of her. You may have been asking her to retrieve something for you that might have been lost. something that might be had left your life, and then you're trying to kind of retrieve it back into your life. You might be asking her. So just kind of go with what resonates and leave what doesn't. So her retrieve. So I don't know how that might play out in you guys' life, but that's what I heard. The next thing I heard is colors. So the colors, I don't know if you've won, many of you guys have been wondering what each color of her cloak means. Or if you've been wondering what color you should choose or which color you should work with. I'm also getting a sense of, you know, the colors of putting colors in her altar. As me myself, I like to, every time I switch her altar, I like to place different altar cloths. Depending on the color, depending on the mood, depending on the season. So I like to play with colors, as colors, you know, makes, adds a vibration to her, as she loves colors. She's very girly. So, you know, she likes, you know, get dressed, indulge in different colors. So I don't know if, you know, if you guys have been wondering about the colors too. So, you know, again, let me know down below in the comments. I could always answer questions if you guys ever had questions. So the next thing I heard is rice. Altar. So I don't know if some of you guys, because I had a vision, she showed me of somebody having her altar on the floor or having it very close to the floor. So she's asking for you to raise her, to put her higher. She does not like to be on the floor. She likes to be in high places. So if you have her on the floor, somebody, please take her off the floor. She does not want to be on the floor. So the last thing I heard is perception changing. So I feel like maybe for my pile one, I feel like for you, my pile one, I feel like you're kind of not, you're not in the first step of working with her. Maybe you're in the second step of working with her, meaning it's like you're not a newbie no more. You know, you might be have already kind of been working with her or, you know, engaging with her more. So you guys might be in the second stage of where your perception is changing around her or around, you know, spirituality, around her craft, her, you know, occult, or, you know, things of how you work with her. So I feel like that's been changing. Your perception's been changing about her. Maybe your perception about her, you know, how in the past, you know, a lot of people think she's evil or stuff like that. You know, maybe your perception is changing in regards to many things in regards to her, which that is good, in which she is acknowledging how your perception is changing towards her. All right, so that's all I have for the channel messages that I received from her. So let's go to your guys' cards to see what you guys have. So we got card 6 and card, I think it's a 6. Yes, 6 in reverse and card number 7. So card number 6 is upside down and card number 6 is the order card. Card number 7 is the feminine energy card. So it's so funny how it's 6 and 7, how I was saying that, you know, you guys might be in the second level, or you guys are on a, you guys are no longer newbies, or you guys are in a different level of working with her. So it's so funny how it's playing out right here. So with the 6 being upside down with the order, I feel like you guys are still getting, again, with the, when I said perception is changing, I feel like you guys are still working on, you know, of the perception, or how you guys work with her. I feel like you guys are still working on connecting with her intuitively, and where you guys are learning to connect with her intuitively, you know, getting your guys' work in order, or, you know, your altar in order, or your practice with her in order. There seems that there's still a lot of things of maybe limitations or beliefs that you guys kind of need to still work through in regards to her. And especially right here with the feminine energy, that gives me, like, you know, how I was saying, you know, with the colors and girly. It's like, you know, she's very girly, feminine energy. Yes, she is tough, and especially when she doesn't fuck around. You know, especially when it's against her devotees, she does not play around. But she is very girly, she is very feminine, she is very compassionate, she's very, you know, alluring, or how can I say, very soft if you let her be, if you let her in. So I definitely see there's different stages that you are, you know, letting go of one stage and going into another stage and working with her. I do see a lot of stuff here, like a lot of clutter. So you might be needing to kind of declutter her altar if you have a lot of stuff on her altar as well, because she does not like to have a very crowded altar, because, you know, things get attached to energy. So a lot of things, so the more things you put on her altar, you know, those things are gathering more more energy. So if you've been trying to communicate with her and you have so many things around her altar, it's going to kind of be difficult for you to pick up on her energy, because you might be picking up on all the energies that are around her altar. I could probably guys show you a quick glimpse of my altar, of how I have it simplified, and is, even if it's so simplified, the energy is higher when I have it more simplified than when I have more things on my altar. So I'll probably show you guys after you guys is reading right now. Let me see what else am I picking up for you guys. So the last thing I'm hearing is, you know, if your guys are planning to do any intuitive work or magic or candle work with her, please make sure you guys do your research. Meditate on what she needs or what she wants in regards to what you guys are offering, or in regards to your petition. Because even when I start to work with her or do work with her, well, she's the only one I work with. So even in regards to that, I tend to kind of meditate on what am I going to need, you know, what are the tools that I'm going to need, and what is she asking for me in return of my petition, as, you know, you have to deliver an offering for your petition. It seems like you guys also are trying to get your life in order. If you guys are trying to get your life in order, make sure to ask her. She can help you get your life in order and simplify your life, and you need to remove anything from your life that needs to go. What else? If you guys feel like, you know, you guys are stuck or need some advice, know that you guys could turn to her for some advice or guidance, but you must remain open to receiving, as this might be, you know, there seems to be a lot going on maybe in you guys' life or around you guys' home, and where it's kind of hard to receive the messages that she wants. So try to meditate with her, meditate by her altar, so you may receive the information and intuitive guidance that you may need, any advice that you may need that you've been asking her in regards to. I heard smile. I don't know why I heard smile. I don't know if, you know, this, because sometimes, you know, even people tell me like, oh, I was talking to her or I was cleaning her altar and I just felt like she was smiling at me. And just know that she was, and she is. You can feel that energy emanating from her statues if you learn or you start to engage with her or you create a bond with her. So yes, she has been smiling at you if you've been feeling like she's been smiling at you. Okay, so last message from a pile one. Since you guys are gonna, since you guys no longer newbies and you guys have kind of, you know, been working with her a little bit longer, you know, she is saying that you guys, it's time to learn more things about her. It's time to dive in more, you know, get more knowledge in regards to her or working with her, so that you guys could go into the next level with the 6 and 7. All right. So that's all I have for pile one. Let me just show you guys my altar real quick, so you guys could just see how simplified it is. So this is my altar, and this is how simplified, how simply it is. And even though it's so simplified, you could still feel the immense energy that she emanates out to me. And again, about the colors, you know, I don't know if you can see, it's a little dark green here, but this is a blue, little light blue, you know, altar cloth. I love to switch her colors throughout the seasons, throughout, you know, depending on the energies and depending on stuff like. Okay, I added some color. So yes, so, you know, here are the apples. So I also create altar cloths. So if, you know, if you guys are interested, I'm also going to put the link down below. Create altar cloths, but they do take a while since I hand embroidered them and hand make them. So yeah, so I even add those, put those type of altar cloths on my altar. Here are my apples, you know, it's everything's so simplified. So, you know, that's just a little quickie little thing for you guys. Pile two, if you pick pile two, this is your reading. So before I go into the cards that you know, something someone wanted to pick for you guys, I'm just gonna go straight to the channel messages I channeled before I did this video. So the first thing I heard was coffee. coffee. So she might be asking you for some coffee as an offering, or she's acknowledging that the coffee that you gave her, or, you know, as she loves coffee. So if you guys have been, you know, wanting to give her some coffee or offering some coffee, or, you know, if you might be drinking some coffee in front of her, she might be asking for some coffee. So just an FYI. So the second thing I heard was music, sing. So she loves music. So if you haven't been playing her any music or singing her or playing any instruments for her as an offering, please do so. She loves it. She loves music. I sing to her and I play music all the time and she loves it. All right. So the next thing I heard was relocation. So with relocation, I'm getting several things from it. So it's either she's asking for you to relocate her altar of where you have her, or also of maybe you are relocating yourself or you're moving and you might not know how to kind of take her with you, or you don't know how to pack her up, or you don't know how to relocate her altar or relocate her things. So one way that you could do, or one thing that you could do is, you know, make sure to always speak to her, as she's always hearing you and she's very understanding. People tend to be very scared of moving her or of touching her or of, you know, creating a bond with her. I don't know why. At first I was the same too, but it's maybe because of the respect that we have her, or the things that we hear on TV or our movies about, you know, if you do one bad thing or that she doesn't like, she's gonna come after you, which is not true. But, you know, if you've been planning on relocating her or relocating yourself and you want to, you know, you're moving homes and you don't know how to place her, you know, just make sure to talk to her. Let her know if you're moving or you're moving her. Make sure you let her know, hey, mi santísima muerte, mi niña, you know, I'm about to do this. I'm going to move you here. I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that. Let her know. Speak to her and she will know and understand and she will give you the go. If you've been planning on relocating her in your home and you don't know where, ask her to show you where you want to be placed. I mean, where she wants to be placed, ask her. If you put her in a place where you just feel this vibe that she's giving you, she might be asking you to relocate her or move her from that place. I also got a vision, or like a vision of one of her statues sitting down, because I've seen some Santa Muerte statues and where she's sitting down like on a chair. So I seen one of the statues. So I don't know if you've been planning on getting one of those statues or been working with one of their statues, or maybe you just got one of the statues. So letting you know that she's aware of it. I also heard reach out. So I don't know if you guys have been wanting to reach out, or maybe she's been reaching out to you and where you haven't been listening, or you haven't been, kind of goes hand in hand with the relocation thing. Maybe she's been telling you or been reaching out and sending you signs and Twitter messages, and it's like it's being hard for her to reach you. As you know, right here, it's funny how, you know, there's an arm right here where it's just, you know, it's kind of reaching out, but it's like it doesn't know, we don't know what she's reaching out to or what she's trying to, you know, kind of do or trying to get. So that's another thing too. I also got hanging. So I don't know if might have some Santa Muerte pictures or something that needs to be hanged, that she's asking you to hang them up already, or maybe you just hang something up in regards to her. Maybe you left her hanging. That's another thing too with the arm. Maybe you left her hanging. Maybe you promised her something, or maybe you might have promised her some coffee and then you haven't given her some coffee, and where you have left her hanging. So she might be asking for that. I also got dreams. I also got a vision of a hand. It's funny how this arm thing or reaching out thing keeps coming up. So I also got a vision of maybe somebody has been having dreams in regards to her. And I also got a dream of like a vision of some maybe having a dream of maybe a skeleton hand coming out of the floor or coming out of the ground or out of a grave or something. Like, that's the vision that I got. So make sure that that's another way that she might be trying to reach out to you. Some of her visions or her dreams could be kind of scary, because I know and I've seen it before and I've received them before, but But yes, she might be trying to reach out to you in different ways that you might not be hearing. So she might be reaching out to you in different ways. So make sure you pay attention to that. I also heard cloak. So I don't know if you guys have been planning to buy her a cloak or maybe a dress. Or been wondering about the different types of cloaks, that what they mean or what each color means. Or, you know, just having questions in regards to her cloak. And if you guys do, don't hesitate to write it down below. I could go ahead and answer the questions to the best of my ability. I also heard incense. So maybe she's asking for some incense, for some incense in your home and her altar. I tend to burn a lot of incense on her, as incense could also be given as an offering, you know. And if you've been wondering what type of incense should you buy or should you get for her, or, you know, just go with what you feel called to get. But one thing that did come out for me was patchouli. She loves patchouli, as patchouli is a underworld herb, very earthly herb. So she loves patchouli. So that's one thing that you guys could offer her if you guys desire. But yes, she's been asking for some incense. So let's get right into you guys' cards. Let's see what my Santísima Muerte has for you guys today. So we got number 11, number 9. I know I'm gonna butcher the names, but you know, I'm just gonna read the names off the book right now because I don't know them by heart. But I believe this is Talok. Talok. But again, I think I'm butchering the names. And then number 11 is Mitekach. I'm butchering it. I'm sorry. But this is the Queen of the Underworld. And it's so funny how we were talking about the underworld herbs of the incense and the patchouli. So we have number 11 and 9. Just for some reason, these cards keep giving me the vibe of her trying to reach out to you guys in the dream state and trying to communicate with you guys and where you guys might not be hearing, because maybe you guys are not aligned fully with her energy, or you guys are not fully grounded in hearing her. And it's so funny how I said about a statue sitting down, and look at her right here sitting down in a chair, or like a chair made out of stones or skulls. And I did not see these cards before I channeled these messages, so I did not see, I'm barely seeing the cards right now for each pile. So yeah, so there's something in regards to this. Maybe you guys are too comfortable where you guys add in, it's time to kind of move again, that relocation thing, or where you might need to relocate her, again, cleansing, or, you know, relocating her from the energies where she might be at. She's definitely been trying to communicate with you guys. What else? If you guys have been asking for petition, or been, you know, asking for some type of wish fulfillment, or for her to grant you a petition, make sure you guys are cleaning out the old offerings and placing new offerings and giving her new offerings. Also, maybe make sure you guys are changing the water for her. I heard opportunity. There's an opportunity coming your guys' way, and where she's trying to communicate with you guys in regards to this opportunity. Could be, you know, it could mean different things, a different opportunity depending on how it plays out in your life. Could be a job, money, partnership, you know, different types of an opportunity that will definitely suit you guys. But it's like she's kind of wanting to guide you. What else? There is something also ending in your guys' life. Again, it could also go hand in hand with the relocation that I kind of, you know, heard at the beginning with your channel message. So there's something that could be something, since, you know, this card is also in regards to death. So, you know, death and rebirth. There's something that is, you know, leaving your guys' life, or you guys are relocating, or they're just a door closing where another door is opening. Again, there's opportunity coming your guys' way. And she's where you've been trying to kind of guide you or warn you or let you know beforehand of something that you guys have been learning, and it's time to incorporate those new insight into this new path that is about to open for you guys. Make sure to stay balanced. Be aware of what you're feeding into, meaning if you're feeding into fear in regards to her, that's what you will reap. If you're feeding into nourishing and nurturing her, that's what you will reap as well. She's asking for some flowers. She wants new flowers. Also, what I've noticed in regards to flowers, she'll let you know which flowers she likes and which she does not like. Please know that just because somebody uses something on their altar does not mean that it's going to work for you. What worked for her will not work for you, and what works for me will not work for you, or what works for you will not work for me. So again, you be very attentive to what she tells you, or what the signs that she gives you. As you know, how I know with the flowers that she does not like is that they die easily, or they get sad easily or quick. If she loves some type of flowers, she will keep them alive as long as they can sustain life on her altar. Also, with saying that, I feel like, you know, you guys need to add some more lively things on her altar, meaning like flowers or a plant or something where you're kind of watering it or having life on her altar. As life cannot exist without death, and death cannot exist without life. Be careful of the information you hear from others. Pay attention to your dreams. That's the same thing I keep hearing. Pay attention to your dreams. Time to let go of the past. Release the skeletons that have been hiding in the closet. There is potential for some healing if that's something that you've been looking for her to, or asking her for some healing, maybe in regards to a family member as well. Know that she can help you with that, but you need to ask her and also give an offering in regards to that. Because it's like, in order to receive, you must give, if that makes sense. So if you're asking for something, you must leave an offering as well. So that's all I'm getting for pile two. I hope it helped. I hope it resonated. And I'll see you guys next time. So pile three. If you pick pile three, this is your reading. So let's see what we have for you guys. So I'm going to start off with the channel messages that I received first before looking at you guys' cards. So the first thing I got was courage. And then at the same time, I got chills. So I don't know if you guys, I feel like this is more of my newbies pile. Because my first pile, I felt like it was the people that who have really been working with her for a while, or were not no longer newbies, but are getting ready to go into the second step or second chapter with my Santísima Muerte. My second pile, I feel like they were more already in tune with her, or already working with her longer. For my third pile, I feel like this is more of my newbies. So for my pile three, so what I heard is courage. So I feel like you guys might be working up the courage, or are finding the courage not to work with her. I feel like, you know, when you're working with her, or you're starting to build a bond with her, or you're speaking with her, some of you guys might be getting chills in that moment. Know that it is her in that moment, that it's her standing next to you. Know that you're speaking to her spirit, and her spirit is coming forward for you in that moment. Don't be afraid, because the next thing I heard was fright for you guys. So don't fright with the things that you feel. as, you know, it's just her letting you know, hey, I'm here. As sometimes, you know, yes, it could be kind of scary, but, you know, once you start building that courage or building that trust with her, you will no longer have the fright. I also got a vision of her scythe. So if also if your Santissima Muerte does not have her scythe, she could not help you cut anything out of your life if you're asking her to cut things out of your life. Every Santissima Muerte statue needs her scythe. I cannot emphasize this enough, and I tell this to everybody. She needs her scythe because her scythe is a part of her, and her scythe is the biggest symbolic thing that represents her, her scythe. So she needs her scythe. So that's another thing. Also, if you need help with cutting things out of your life, make sure to ask her. Ask her, you know, please cut off these things out of my life. Cut these people out of my life. Cut this, you know, obsessive thinking out of my life, or these toxic things out of my life. You know, ask her, you know, work with her. Start, you know, engaging with her in those type of ways. I also heard propaganda. So make sure, be aware of what you're hearing, what you're looking into, especially in all those weird ass YouTube videos, because before I started this video, I was seeing a lot of weird YouTube videos in regards to her, and I was just like, what the fuck is this? But yeah, so because when I started working with her, I did not go to anybody else or ask anything or started searching up videos or things of how to work with her. Just use your intuition. She guides you. She, you know, everybody is different. Everybody works different. You know, so if you are planning to work with her or starting to engage with her, you know, start to, the guidance that I could give you guys first is to create the bond with her. Once you create that bond with her, is everything will come intuitively, or everything will start falling into place when working with her. So yeah, so just be aware of the propaganda that you might be hearing, or the propaganda that you might be reading through or engaging with in regards to her, because some of it might not be truth. It might be coming from a fearful space instead of coming from a spiritual space, if that makes sense. I also heard they can't hear me. So maybe she's been trying to communicate with you guys, but you guys have not been able to hear her because you guys still have not built that bond with her in order for, you know, so again, with the propaganda and they cannot hear me kind of goes hand in hand. So you guys might be looking for answers or things outside of you with other people, in which that's kind of blinding you of what she's trying to communicate with you. So, you know, instead of going out looking for answers outside of you, try to look for the answers inside of you and with her, so that way you could hear what she's been trying to tell you. So I also got color and choosing color. So you guys might be wanting to work with her as well and been wanting to choose a color, or been finding or been trying to see which color best suits you. So again, just go with the color that pulls you, because you know the color pulls you, because the first Santissima Muerte that I got was the Siete Potencias, the statue, and then I got the black one. So just kind of go with what pulls you. Many people like to start with the white one, as she's more gentle, her energy is more gentle, more subtle. But again, just go with what pulls you and what energy pulls you towards her. So if you've been wondering what color you should work with, just follow your intuition, and you know, just tell her, you know, which color should I go with first, or you know, and then just she'll tell you. Trust me, she will tell you and she will show you. Especially if you ask her a question, she'll make sure that comes in your face and she'll make sure you see it. So I heard move now or where. So I don't know if you've been wondering to where to put her or how to put her or how to move her and stuff like that. So, you know, again, just follow your intuition. Always speak to her, especially if I'm gonna move her or do whatever. I always speak to her, tell her, Niña, you know, I'm about to do this. If you don't like it, please let me know, or please guide me in how you want me to place you, which way to place you, how to place you, and stuff like that. So make sure to kind of, you know, that's why creating a bond with her is so important when working with me, Santissima Muerte. So the next thing I heard is car protection. So I don't know if you guys need to kind of protect your guys' car, or you guys have been trying to protect your guys' car, or you guys might be placing some Santissima Muerte you know, like little postcards or anything inside your car to help you protect your car. Know that she's aware of it and she is protecting your car. Or you've been wondering if how she could protect your car, you know, placing one of you know, one of these cards in your car could also help out tremendously. You know, if you need protection in your car, make sure to let her know. You know, that's just one thing that I picked up. So, all right. So that's all I got for the channel messages. So let's dive right into you guys' cards. So we got number 4 and number 10. So this card is the love card. Number 4 is the love card. And number 10 is the Mictatecholi. I know I'm not saying it right, but forgive me. So let's see. And it's just funny what the, you know, the book says in regards to you guys' cards. As you know, number 4, it says act responsibility, bearing in mind not only your needs, but also what they will cause in the environment you live in. And this card says, it is time to look at the situation for a more in-depth point of view, to analyze the circumstances before putting the pieces back together. And again, this is, you know, in regards to kind of analyzing what you're hearing, with the propaganda of the information that you may be hearing, the information you might be receiving from other people, from what type of source are you receiving the information. As you know, not all information you're receiving goes hand in hand with you or aligns with your energy or aligns with your being, if that makes sense. Because like I always say, you know, everybody works with her differently, but everybody works with her depending how they align with her energy, because everybody aligns differently. Everybody has different intentions. Everybody has a different perspective. Everybody has a different energy. So again, make sure you are connecting with her first or creating a bond first before you start working with her or start incorporating what other people do. Because in, like I say, what works for other people might not work for you, or what works for you might not work for them. Again, for my group number 3, like, I feel like you guys are my baby, you know, baby Santísima Muerte devotees. As you know, with number 4, you know, 4 is always that building, that connection, or building that foundation. Building that foundation in order to connect with your deity. So, again, it's that, it starts with the spark, it starts with the little seed, it starts with the manifestation, it starts with an intention to build a connection with your deity, which is Santísima Muerte. Let go, right? Let go of all the propaganda, or let go of all the negative things that you may hear from her, or let go from what you thought you knew, so that you may receive the information that you need in order to work with her. Because, you know, there's some bloodshed here. So I feel like, you know, a lot of people feel like they need to sacrifice all these major things in order to work with her, or sacrifice major things in order to ask her for things, or to, you know, in order for her to answer a petition, that you feel like you need to sacrifice certain things, or you feel like you're gonna sacrifice a family member in order for her to freaking, you know, answer a petition for you, which everything is wrong. It's wrong. It's not correct. So make sure you are building that connection first with her before you start, you know, asking things. Let me see if there's any final things that I need to say before I close out your guys' reading. Is there anything else? Me something so more to this group. Number 3 needs to hear. Anything else? I heard shatter. So shatter the, she said, shatter the perception you had of me. Because, okay. I understand. Okay. So she's saying just how there's different colors of me, there's different levels, there's different perspectives, there's different vibes of me. I have many faces but one bond. Okay, so that's all I have for pile three. I hope it helped. I hope it resonated. Let me know what you guys think down below. If you guys have any questions, don't hesitate to, you know, to comment down below and I can answer any questions that you'd like. If you guys would like to follow me on Instagram, again, my Instagram handle is at charm_wisdom. I also do weekly Santa Muerte questions where I can answer questions for a low price of $13.13 of, you know, asking questions maybe in regards to her, any personal questions of how to work with her. So I do those in my Instagram. So if you guys would like to follow me on Instagram, go ahead and do so, please. So again, if you guys would like to donate the Santísima Muerte tarot deck to my channel, if you guys feel called to, or please go ahead and do so, so that way I could create more videos like this and more content to help you guys along this, you know, this journey of getting close to our Santísima Muerte. So I hope this reading has brought you love, light, and blessings to all my Santísima Muerte devotees, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.